Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
How you doing, sir? What's your name?
My name is Chris.
Chris? Oh, nice. What's your name, bro?
Government.
What's your name? Yo, Shalom? All right. Listen, this your son?
Yeah.
All right, so I got a question, right? Because you said you know you're Israel, right? That's a beautiful thing. What tribe you from?
Yes, sir.
What tribe you from?
I'm from the tribe of Judah, man.
All praises. You're from the tribe of Judah, all right. Now, you said that you congregate already. You have a camp that you congregate.
Yeah.
Okay, who do you congregate with?
Everybody that I can.
Everybody you can?
Everybody.
Read 1 Corinthians 1 and 2.
The Israelites.
The people ain't woke. Okay, the Bible is real specific of who we have to congregate with. You can't just congregate with anybody, because not everybody has the same mind. Not everybody believes that Christ is a black man. Not everybody believes that the Israelites are the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. These are the people who we have to congregate with. Read.
My bad. The book of 1 Corinthians! Chapter 1 and verse 10.
Read it out.
Now I beseech you, brethren.
Brethren. So this is Paul, the Apostle Paul, Israelite from the tribe of Benjamin. He's talking to his brethren, not everybody. His brethren, the 12 tribes of Israel. Yeah. Not all nations. Read.
Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that ye all speak the same thing.
You all do what?
Speak the same thing.
So listen, if you're congregating with people who believe, who don't believe, other nations, do you guys all speak the same thing? No, you guys won't speak the same thing. What must you be speaking? What must we be speaking as a believer, as us knowing we are the children of Israel?
True.
What's the truth? Psalms 119:142. Give me the truth. What's the truth, brother? You know, what's the truth? Yeah, what's the truth? Because a lot of people say they know the truth, we gotta teach the truth, but what's the truth?
The commandments.
All right, we're gonna read that, read.
The book of Psalms. Chapter 119:142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth.
So you said it. The law is the truth. That's the thing we're supposed to be speaking. Right. So guess what? If you're amongst other people who are not speaking the truth, guess what? They're going to cause you to go off. They're going to cause you to go away from the truth. So guess what? You got to be amongst like-minded believers of this truth who are going to do what? Teach you and your son how to keep the commandments. Teach you how to be an example to your people. Give me that Judith 8:24. All right, because that's what we're doing. That's why we come out here. It's not to put on a flashy show. It's to teach our people. All right, Judith 8:24. Read that.
Judith 8:24. Now therefore, O brethren, let us show an example to our brethren, because their hearts depend upon us.
Their hearts depend on who?
Their hearts depend upon us.
So guess what? Your people on this side, they depend on you. There's a lot of our brothers and sisters that don't know they're Israel. That don't know they're from the tribe of Judah, tribe of Issachar, Zebulun. You guys know that information. So guess what? The Bible's saying that you guys have to be that example. How do we be that example? Matthew 5:16. All right, the Bible's going to teach us step by step. And we need teachers to teach us how to be that example. How to keep the commandments and the faith of the Jesus Christ, the black Messiah. Read that, Matthew 5:16.
Matthew 5:16. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works.
So it said, let your light shine before men, meaning before the whole world to see our people, you may glorify God. So guess what? What is our light? What is our light?
Glorifying God.
How? Because a lot of people in the Christian church, Catholic church, Presbyterian church, the Mormon church, they praise God every Sunday. They praise God. So what separates you from all those other ideologies, all those other beliefs? What's going to separate you from the other people?
Well, you got Proverbs 6:23? Gospel.
The gospel? Okay.
I mean,
You got an answer, young man? What's gonna separate you, because you say you glorify God. What's gonna separate you from the people in the Christian church, from the Catholic church, from the Mormon church, from Islam? Because they all say they glorify God. But there's only one truth, God's laws and commandments. I'm giving you guys a clue. God's laws and commandments is the truth. These other denominations, these other philosophies and doctrines of devils, they don't teach God's laws and commandments. So read that, Proverbs 6:23, because Christ said, let your light so shine. What's your light? What is your light? Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 6 and verse 23.
Read.
For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light.
So the law is light. So the same thing as the truth. So guess what? We got to keep the commandments. Zephaniah 2 and 1.
Gather yourself together, all nations not divided.
So at your congregation, right, what exactly do they teach you?
Well, you know, we're amongst teaching ourselves. We don't want to go on the internet and
So you guys like hold classes and you guys stream online?
Yeah, no, we're not online. When we go online, we verbalize through music.
So you guys spread the gospel through music?
Through the music.
Okay, exactly. All praise. Well, we got many people who have that talent of music to spread the gospel. But the thing is, we gotta make sure we're putting forth the right message. Right? Because there's a lot of, we got God, like I said, I'm gonna go back to the Christian church because a lot of us are familiar with that background. You got the gospel singers, they teach about Christ. Or so-called Christ, but their message is nothing, doesn't align with the Bible.
I'm aware of that. I know Nate Daniel and all.
We got to teach God's laws and commandments.
All of you, what you guys are teaching right now, I got about 1,000 of y'all videos.
So guess what? Read this. Zephaniah 2 and 1, read that.
The book of Zephaniah, chapter 2 and verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation not desired.
Does the Bible say stay at home and make music?
No.
Gather yourselves together, O nation not desired.
But I can ask you a question. If I was just staying home making music, would I ever be talking to you guys right now?
No.
Okay.
What I'm saying, this is talking about congregating. This is talking about congregating with like-minded believers. Remember, that's what I came up and asked you. Who do you congregate? Who do you fellowship with? If you guys are alone by yourself, who's gonna teach you? Who is teaching you?
What? You guys.
No.
You guys are teaching me.
I understand that. But before today. Who was teaching you?
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
You was watching how you watch see on
I watch all, that's how I, oh, yeah. I watch all, I got, I probably can tell you, I got every video that Nate Daniel and them put out.
Okay,
I got it all.
So you watch Israel United in Christ.
Yeah, and I ain't saying I know more than you guys,
okay.
But I'm saying that's who I'm studying you guys.
Okay, understood. But read what you got. Read it again.
The book of Zephaniah, chapter 2 and verse 1. Gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired.
This question, you seen our elder Bishop Nathaniel, right? Is he at home teaching?
Nah.
Where is he at?
He's doing videos.
He's doing classes. He's traveling.
He's
in the camps teaching our people. He's not hiding what he knows. And that's what I'm trying to tell you. You can learn. That's all praises that you're learning online. You're watching videos. All praise. But guess what? Your knowledge level is going to be limited. You have to be around other men to show you that example. People got to show you how to live. So guess what? You can shine your light. Your son can shine his light and teach others.
And that's why we're standing right here, right now.
Psalm 94.
That's why we're standing here right now, because you know, through the videos, you know, I know he puts out stuff where you can contact him and all that.
Right.
You guys are California based, right?
Yes.
California based, right?
We have camps in California.
I'm contacting you guys right now.
Okay. You got a flyer, right?
That's all that matters, right?
You got a flyer, right?
You got a flyer for me now.
Yeah, I got flyers.
Okay.
Remember, I was in the turning lane. I got flyers.
Listen. Our information out there, but hear this real quick. Read.
Turn left.
The book of Psalms, chapter 94, verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
That's a question. Read it again.
Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
So God is asking, who amongst my people that know that the Israelites are gonna rise up against the evildoers? That's a question. That's the question we come out and ask our people. Who's gonna be with us and teach God's laws and commandments? Teach our people who they are. Teach our people that they're in the midst of sin and they gotta repent.
Right.
Who's gonna do that? That's the question.
Right.
We can't do it on our own, right? And I'm not knocking you, bro, because when I first came in, I was watching videos. But eventually, I had to take that leap of faith and say, you know what, I'm going to get with the brothers, and I'm going to join the men in purple, and I'm going to push this truth. I'm going to go pass out fire. I'm going to build myself up. I'm going to build my house up, and I'm going to teach my people and be that example, like it says in Judith 8:24. And that's what you got to ask. Because guess what? This is your son who looks up to you.
Right.
And that's a beautiful thing that you get. You're raising your son. Because there's a lot of men out there that are like you. They don't got the spirit that you got to raise their family. So people got to see that example that you're bringing forth.
That's right.
But you can't do it at your home.
That's right.
You got gifts. You got talents. You got gifts. You got talents.
Sure enough, this is my family.
Right.
You all are.
Yes, we could be family.
We could be family.
But we don't want to be that distant family we see you once a year on a family reunion. No. The Bible says, gather yourselves together every Sabbath. Today is the Sabbath day. And guess what? After we pack up and leave, guess where we're going? With our families, with our wives, with our children, with our brothers, our sisters. We're going to congregate and fellowship with our families.
That's right.
And that's what you got to do, because guess what? This world is evil. You can't conquer the world by yourself. You can't conquer the world by yourself. So my main thing to you, brother, you got to make that decision to start congregating. We got the address. We got the school information. We got teachers. Right, that can teach you everything that you need to know, to build yourself up, to help us overcome and rise up against the evildoers. Because this world is evil, and Christ is coming back.
Right.
All right, so we need men and strong men like you and your son.
Leviticus 19:17. Show them what commandments he can't keep.
All right, Leviticus 19:27.
He needs people around him to keep commandments, right? So show him what commandments he can't keep.
Go ahead. All right, because it's very important to learn. You can't learn it on yourself. You can't do it by yourself. I tried. When I first learned, we tried. Me and my brothers, we tried, but you can't do it. Leviticus 19:17.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 17. Uh-huh. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
What does that mean? What does it mean when the Bible says thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart? You don't understand? Okay, read it again.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
It says we shouldn't hate our brother in the heart. Read.
Thou shalt in any wise.
But on the contrary, read.
Rebuke thy neighbor.
So guess what? When you don't rebuke your neighbor, what does rebuke mean?
Rebuke means like.
Say it in the mic. No. Come here. What does it mean?
Rebuke basically means like. Basically said, I rebuke you, like, get away from you.
No, rebuke
is more like the rebuke means that get rid of an evil spirit or...
Close, you're on the right track. Yeah. It means to sharply correct somebody.
Correct somebody, yeah.
Correct somebody according to God's law. So guess what?
Exactly.
When you see your people in the midst of sin, you got to be, hey, bro, put that cigarette down. Hey, bro, you shouldn't be staring at women's behinds like that. Hey, bro, don't do this because it goes against God's law. So read it from the top, because we gotta explain what hatred is. When you know God's laws and commandments, and you don't correct your brothers, God calls it hate. Read it again.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
Right, so if you know the laws and commandments, you're not supposed to hate your brother in the heart, read.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor, and not suffer sin upon him.
Right, and you shouldn't suffer sin about it. So if you're home by yourself, who are you correcting? Nobody. Nobody. You see the importance of God saying, gather yourself together? You see the importance of it? So you learn the laws and commandments, and now you teach it. You can't do it on your own. We got to gather together. Right? All right, another law. Give me Leviticus 5 and 1, right? Because this is along the same way. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 5 and verse 1. And if thy soul sin.
So if your brother or your sister sins, read.
And hear the voice of swearing.
So you hear them swear or sin against God, read.
And is a witness, whether he hath seen or known of it.
So whether you seen your brother in sin or you heard it, right, and you're a witness to it, read.
If he do not utter it.
If you do not utter it, what's that mean?
Utter it.
You see your brother and sister in the midst of sin, if you do not utter it, what does that mean?
Stop it.
Okay, kind of. You gotta say something to him. Listen, if your son, right, was walking in the middle of the street, right, and there was a car coming, he don't see it, what you gonna be like? And you're like, hey, watch out.
Exactly.
You gonna be like, hey, watch out. No, you're gonna be like, hey, watch out, you in the midst of, hey, watch out, there's a car coming. That's how we have to treat sin.
Right.
Because guess what? When we see our people in the midst of sin, give me that in Romans 6:23. When we see our people in the midst of sin and they're ignorant to what's going on, they're going to get put to death. God's judgment is going to come upon them, right? So it's our job to teach our people the laws and commandments, to correct them on where they're going off, right? That's what we do out here, right? Read that.
The book of Romans, chapter 6 and verse 23. Uh-huh. For the wages of sin is death.
What's the wages of sin?
Yeah.
What does that mean, though? What is for the wages of sin is death? What's that mean?
You want to inherit the kingdom.
You want to inherit the kingdom. Right. For example, if someone smokes cigarettes, right, what's going to be the end result of that?
Cancer.
Huh?
Cancer.
He's gonna die. He's going to get diseases in his lungs, right? If someone is a whoremonger sleeping from woman to woman to woman, what's going to be the end result of that? He's going to get an STD. He's going to get AIDS, HIV. And depending if he has the money for medication, he's going to end up dying. So guess what? The Bible is explaining the importance of teaching our people they're in the midst of sin.
Right.
Right? But guess what? It starts with you, though. You got to figure out what laws and commandments we got to keep. Numbers 15. Right? Here's another law that will help us. Right? Because all this is a spiritual thing. It's a spiritual thing. We're going to get the kingdom by keeping the laws and commandments. We're not going to get the kingdom by marching. We're not going to get the kingdom by getting guns and forming a military to overthrow the government. No, our military is about keeping God's laws and commandments and the faith of Jesus Christ. Right? Read number 15.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 37.
And what we're going over are basic scriptures that we can apply to our lives after the sun goes down. This is a commandment you can apply. Read.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, mm-hmm. Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations.
So God told Moses to tell the children of Israel, put ye fringes on the border of your garments. So at the border of our garments, on all of our t-shirts that we wear, we gotta put fringes and what?
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
So every brother you see out here, right, teaching this word, we got fringes and a border of blue. But why do we wear it? Why do you think we wear the fringes? Because God doesn't give us laws for no reason. Why do we wear fringes?
I think it's identity. Yes, it's a thought, but I don't know per se about it knowledge-wise, but I think it's identification.
Okay, all praise. So it's a spiritual thing, right? God, yes, it is to separate. Our dress code, God gave us the best dress code on the planet. No other nation can match our dress code. We got fringes. We got warlike apparel. God gave that culture of clothing, of dress wear to the Israelites, right? But keep reading. He's going to explain to us why we wear fringes. Read.
Verse 39, uh-huh. And it shall be unto you for a fringe, uh-huh. that ye may look upon it.
So you're supposed to put fringes on your shirt and look with your eyes upon them. Read.
And remember all the commandments of the Lord.
Remember what?
All the commandments of the Lord.
We're supposed to remember. These fringes are reminders to keep the commandments, to gather together, to not eat shrimp, pork, crab, and lobster, to wear a beard on our face. Give me that Leviticus 19. Right? Because you got a beard, brother.
I know.
You got a beard.
On the edges of your,
The edges of the beard, or the edges of your head, right? We're going to get that, right? Because guess what? You know that. Does your son know that?
Yeah.
He knows that. Okay. So now, you guys both know that. So when you see the next brother that don't have a beard on, you can tell he's shaved and he's bald his hair. What do you tell that brother? What scripture would you give that brother? So here's the scripture someone asked.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 27. You shall not round the corners of your heads, neither shalt thou mar the corners of thy beard.
So you ain't supposed to shave your head off like Michael Jordan, like Steve Harvey, like all these celebrities, right? You're not supposed to mar your head, or you're supposed to shave off your beard. You can trim it up, make nice. But guess what? You're being a good example to your son, but you gotta be an example to the whole world now. You can't no more hide it, right? Now, let's transition real quick, because those are a few commandments that we can keep. But I gotta ask you, what is stopping you from congregating? How long have you been watching?
What the IUIC?
Yeah, how long have you been watching? That sounds like you've been watching for a minute. How long have you been watching?
Maybe about 6 years.
6 years? You've been watching for 6 years, brother. What is stopping you from coming in?
You know, a lot of downfalls, financial problems, all kind of things, but I'm getting back there.
Okay.
Homeless for a minute. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, so let me ask you a question. You think in the body right now we don't got people dealing with financial problems? You don't think people are dealing with marital problems? You don't think people are dealing with job problems? We all got problems. And the only way you're gonna get solutions is by congregating. So for you to say that, brother, I'm not trying to downplay what you're going through. I get it, it's real. We're under oppression. But guess what? We cannot make that an excuse to not keep God's laws and commandments. Read that.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 28 and verse 13.
Uh-huh.
He that covereth his sins shall not prosper.
And though you might not be doing it intentionally, for you to be staying home and not congregating, you're covering up your sins. There's some sin in you that you don't want revealed out of shame, right? Or out of regret, right? But guess what? Read that from the top.
He that covereth his sins shall not prosper.
So you're not going to prosper. Though you're doing the music thing, all praises, but guess what? That thing's not going to prosper. God is not going to let you be a prosperous man, you or your son, if you cover up your sins. The only way you can uncover your sin is by congregating with people. Let brothers, and you don't tell everybody. I'm not saying you go to the camp and tell everybody what's going on. You learn, you find a counselor, right? And you let them know, hey, sir, I'm dealing with this. I'm dealing with financial problems. I'm dealing with this job situation. I'm dealing with paying my mortgage, my rent, whatever the case may be. You find a counselor, one of a thousand, and he's going to help you build you up. He's going to help you build you up, but you can't do it alone, brother. Every single man out here, we got problems. We got problems. And that's why we run into the Bible, to get answers to our problems. But we can't find it on our own. We cannot find it on our own. Deuteronomy 10 and 12 again, bro. All right, because we showed you a little bit of commandment that you guys can keep, like what? Don't shave your beard. Don't shave your head off. What else? What else? What else?
What commandments to keep?
Yeah. What commandments? Like what? Your fringes?
Holy Sabbath. Yeah.
Fringes? We got to keep the Sabbath. We got to congregate.
The Sabbath.
Right. Deuteronomy 10 and 1 Samuel 2 and 3. 1 Samuel 2 and 3. That's that. 1 Samuel 2 and 3. Because guess what? You've been learning. Now you've seen the prophets. Now there's no more excuse. Christ said he's coming back like what?
Like a thief in the night.
A thief in the night. When's the thief coming? You don't even know. Hey, there could be a thief at my house right now. There could be a thief at your house.
Yeah,
Christ is coming like a thief in the night. So if you ain't prepared, you're going to miss the ticket. You're going to miss them chariots coming to redeem us. Read.
1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 3. Talk no more exceeding proudly.
Uh-huh.
Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Because there's many people that came up to you like, I know that. I came up. I've been watching y'all. But they never congregate. So it's a lot of talk. God's saying it's a lot of talk. A lot of arrogancy coming out your mouth. Read it from the top again.
Talk no more exceeding proudly. Uh-huh. Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Uh-huh.
For the Lord is a God of knowledge.
So God is a God of knowledge. He knows what you're going through. He knows what's going to happen for you tomorrow. He's going to be the one that's going to protect you. But you got to humble down and keep his commandments. Read.
And by him, actions are weighed.
No, words are weighed.
By him, actions are weighed.
So God is weighing our actions. God is going to hold you accountable for what you know, and he's going to see what you're going to do about it.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.